Zapraszam Was na rozmowę z Mikkelem Rygartem, nowym pomocnikiem UKS-u. Hi, Mikkel.
Hello.
First, you've been training in UKS for a month. What do you enjoy? How do you enjoy it?
It's been really good. I mean, a lot of new impressions, new players, new coach. I need to adapt to many new things, but so far the guys have been really nice to me and trying to get me involved in a team. So far it's been a lot of new information, but it's been good so far, and I'm just happy to be here.
Do you like the style of playing game UKS?
Yes, very much. I mean, that was also one of the reasons why I wanted to come here, because you like to play football on the ground, the football I like. The coach is he like Guardiola's playing style very much, and I'm a big fan of Guardiola and the teams he's been coaching. So I'm very happy about the playing style we play here.
On the training, we can see that you are a very technical player, and I think it's your favorite and the most feature, I think.
Yes, of course. I'm known as a technical player. I'm not really the biggest or the strongest, but my force, if you can say, is my technical ability. So yeah, I think you spot on with that. So hopefully I can help the team with my technical and my playmaking skills and the way I think football.
So who is the player who you like the most playing with on training?
So far I've been playing a lot with the Spanish boys, with Pirulo and Antonio, and I've been playing a little bit with Trombi too. So I mean, they always put me in the team with them, and so far I think we've been finding each other really good, and I enjoy playing with the guys because they're also very technical and think football the way I think. So it's been easy to play with these guys.
You three, I mean, you and Antonio and Pirulo, has left leg better than right.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, if you ask some of the Spanish guys, they probably would say they're good with both legs. But I mean, almost all of the left footers is much better on the left than they are with the right. So that's the same with me. Of course, I prefer shooting with my left and my right. But I think if the ball would lay to my right foot, of course I would shoot with my right. But definitely, I prefer playing with my left foot.
Okay. Not only on the pitch, but also in the free time, you spent a lot of time with Spanish guy. I think that the most time you spent with Pirulo. Do you enjoy him?
Yes. I mean, Pirulo and Carlos has been really nice to me since I came here. Outside the training and the club, they've been really helpful and invited me for dinner. So we've been hanging out a little bit, and they're really fun guys and wants to make a lot of fun in the team, and I enjoy spending time with them. So far these two guys have been, what can you say, everybody's been really nice to me, but they have taken me under the wing, if you can say, more than anybody else, and I enjoy okay. Being around them, yes.
Okay, so in which also he and they are your private guides.
Yeah, you can say that. I've been hanging out with these two guys in Łódź. So that has helped me to settle down more in Łódź. But of course, my girlfriend will come after training camp, and that will definitely help me too. But they've been really nice at welcoming me to the team and showing me around in the town as well.
Do you see a difference between training in UKS and training in your former clubs in Danish?
Yes, of course. It's of course two different countries, a Scandinavian club and this club here is doing things different, and that's normal. You cannot have the same in both places, but it's still two teams who wants to have the ball a lot, but of course there is a big difference in the two training sessions, if you can say that.
Okay, and what is the biggest difference in trainings? One biggest difference?
I think I would probably say that the training intensity in my former club was so far higher, but I've only been here in Łódź for only 1 month now, so maybe I will get there, but so far the biggest difference has been the training intensity during trainings.
Okay. But I think on camp you have more intensity training than you have in Łódź, because here you have 2 trainings per day.
Yes, of course. They have, what can you say, pushed the limit more here in training camp, because we have 2 trainings every day and we've been running a lot too, and you can see the guys are really fighting to get in shape. So of course they pushed on the intensity, and I can start to feel it now. So yeah, it's good, and we're trying to get in shape for the first game.
Are you a player who run a lot during the game, or you prefer staying in the middle and just passing crosses?
No, I've always been a guy who likes to run around the pitch. I mean, where the ball is, I am next to it almost. So I like to run a lot. And in my former club, I was one of the guys who ran the most. But they wanted me to have more high intense meters and sprint more. And during my time in my former club, I had more of this, but I've always covered a lot of meters. So of course I like to run around, but mostly when we have the ball. It's not fun to run without the ball, but it's much more fun to have the ball.
I guess it, because the next question will be about your favorite position. Do you like be this 8 with running a lot, or maybe 10 who is playmaking and being with the striker, or maybe winger?
My favorite position is number 10. I like to be, as you said, the playmaker. I like to combine and set up the play and make assists, sometimes score myself. So I would say definitely my favorite position is 10, but I also like to play number 8 sometimes, because then you're more involved with the build-up, you can get down and help with the build-up. So it depends sometimes, but my favorite position is number 10.
Do you feel a Viking? Because the fans made up such a nickname for you.
Okay, I mean, of yeah, in Scandinavia, Denmark, you back in the day you were called Vikings. So for me it's no problem. I cut my hair too, so maybe it helps with the Viking nickname. But yeah, I don't know. I can go with Viking. That's fine for me.
Yeah. Which character features create Vikings?
I think what creates a Viking is somebody who is brave, is strong, and I don't know, believe in himself, I think, and yeah, I'm not really sure what else a Viking does, because it's it's really back in the day, but I think that a guy who's really strong and believes in himself and is brave and maybe, yeah.
And on the pitch you are like Viking, or only by place of birth?
Maybe by place of birth, but of course, I don't know, a Viking always go into to win, and of course I want to win. There's nothing else I want, so maybe you can compare with this, that I really want to win and do everything it takes. But as a player, I'm not really the one who smashes people and tackle and all this. But of course, it's not like I'm just gonna let people run past me. I'm gonna try to do my best. But yeah, I just want to win.
Okay. The last question of this interview will be about your plans for the second part of season in Poland. I mean, your personal plans and team plans.
First of all, the team plan is is to get up in Ekstraklasa. That's our big, big goal, and everybody works really hard for this. And I believe that we can do it. My personal plans is, of course, helping the team, helping the fans and the club to achieve this goal, to go in Ekstraklasa. And that's my personal dream too. I came here because I wanted this team to go in Ekstraklasa, and because I believe that we can do it. And I'm here to help with goals and assists and good play and all this. So that's my personal goal for my stay here.
At the really last of the interview, do you want to say something to the fans?
Yes, I'm really looking forward to play in front of you guys. I've heard many good things, and I've been looking at YouTube and all kind of things to see how good and how loud you are during the games. And I hope that soon everybody will be back in the stadium, so we all can try to achieve our goal to go in Ekstraklasa. But I'm really looking forward to play for you guys, and hopefully I'll see you soon. Do zobaczenia na stadionie.